as long as nobody died here today or nobody's life was ruined here today, we have the opportunity in classrooms to continue to take risk.
A group of people showing their rear end to what looks like a minister or a reverend.
Now, most people think of New South Wales as the gold standard in content-driven curriculum, and we decided to flip it.
Deliberately chose this source to get you thinking. This is a time in education where we're really at a pathway to change our focus to develop dispositions as opposed to content.
What they used to call soft skills, and in some contexts it's still called soft skills, but they're essential skills.
Students need to be prepared for multiple career changes, that the job market will probably look totally different to what we have now in a decade. A critical and creative inquiry cycle was this drive to encourage the dispositions for 21st century learning, where creativity and critical thinking are very much at the heart.
The nature of the program emphasised that students' creativity was not fixed, that it was able to be developed over time.
Students were really hesitant to recognise traits that were creative. They often associated creativity with being to do with the creative arts, whether that be, you know, art or music, and if they thought that they weren't any good at that, they had this idea that they weren't creative in any way whatsoever. Things like tolerating uncertainty and looking at different options, and how is it that you might respond under pressure, and that things that as humans we need to be able to do to adapt or to be divergent or to respond to a problem are all actually traits of creativity.
The strategies that we use at school helped me a lot through learning by making me think about a lot of other stuff that I wouldn't have thought of before. We're looking about the Holocaust denials in class, and it said how fake news and everything was going around on social media. It also, the source that we used also made me think about how the fake news have spread around the world, and it actually makes me think about how I see things on the news and everything now.
If our students can really deconstruct knowledge in the 21st century, not have a teacher do it for them, if they can take control and own their own understanding, they can achieve anything. That's what we have to believe, and it's around shifting pedagogy.
Teachers can provide students with tools to help them be empowered to actually find relevant information and analyse that, being able to collaborate with one another.
I never want to see another worksheet.
As a history teacher and humanities teacher, being inquisitive, I guess, is often the foundation of being able to drive questioning in students. The idea of historiography or the fact that history is contested becomes one of our major themes.
It was hard to wrap my head around that there is no right or wrong answer at first, but then that can also be interesting as well because you can look at two different perspectives.
So for the Do Now activity or the introduction yesterday, had found a source about women in Van Diemen's Land actually in a flash mob mooning the governor. That as a source very much, I think, challenged the students' thinking in terms of, is this real? Is this something that we actually believe? Why are the women doing that? That then led the way to thinking about whether punishments in the penal colonies of Australia was too harsh. And that was the big idea or the driving question for the lesson. This year 9 class, where they're really grappling at different perspectives and encouraged to look at each other's perspectives and come up with their own, has led to conversations between each other and their writing when they're reflecting using higher order language, academic terms, and some of the conversations have been very similar to what we would expect of year 11 and year 12. You're going to argue for new ideas by justifying your prior knowledge with the historical sources that you're going to look at today, and then you're going to consolidate your arguments.
So they're not just recalling facts, they're actually being able to articulate how they're learning and how they're thinking.
How would you describe it in terms of empathy?
We could have stayed with a more traditional approach, and we could be quite content for our students to grow at the 9 months. But if 60 to 80% of your cohort arrive in year 7 below grade average, you can't afford to just grow at the 9 months or they'll never catch up. People would forgive us. They would say, oh, well, it's a Western Sydney school after all. You know, we can't expect teachers to do much about that. We can't expect the kids to achieve really well. It's not good enough.
Students are really enjoying this method of learning because it promotes student agency. student choice in topic choices and being able to value each other's opinion. They'll stay back and tell you if they really enjoyed a lesson. They'll also tell you if, you know, you've used too many of the same strategies.
And we're not naive. We believe in evidence-informed practice. The group that we started with was the group that were in Year 7. They were in Year 10 last year. So on external measures when they started Year 7, 80% of them were below grade average and 60% were below grade 4. When they finished Year 10 last year, based on the valid science test, it's one of the very few that allow students to show all of their skills, 70% of our students had reached state average.
There's constant checkpoints which enable students and peers and teachers to be able to collaborate together and give feedback, mutual feedback, about how they're progressing.
Now that we have an online digital portfolio, it's called My Learning Hub, students upload evidence against each of the capabilities. At the end of this next 6 months, we'll be actually able to do an audit across the school of the types of evidence that students are uploading and whether they're achieving at or above the ACARA benchmarks. We'll be actually able to map it.
As a school, as we work to really connect the creative inquiry cycle to self-assessment in terms of using My Learning Hub and personalised learning, I definitely think that students being able to reflect has increased confidence.
It's good to know in your mind what you've accomplished when you're doing classwork, so you know what you're capable of.
To trial something this different in our programming model was a risk. But what I know when people come here is that they can see students who actually do have a growth mindset, who believe in effort, who believe that if they invest in themselves, they can make a real change. It doesn't matter where you start, it only matters where you finish.
Teaching has to be about creating opportunities for students to develop the skills that they actually need as an adult, for them to have fulfilling lives, really.